This is Nick from Lake Geneva Country Meats. I'm here with my Uncle Mark. Everybody knows I don't like fish.
But I do.
He's also a great fisherman.
And I love eating fish. So what I said was, you know, while I'm here visiting, we should do a fish recipe.
So I said, let's go ahead. And he said, we're going to use Mahi Mahi. I said, ah, the fish so nice, they named it twice.
Badoomch. So, but you can use any fish. Everybody knows you need good meat, you go to Lake Geneva Country Meats. In case you don't know, if you need good fish, same place. So there are quite a few different fish. Mahi Mahi works, tilapia works, lots of different fish. You want a fish that's not real flavorful, because what we're doing is adding a little flavor. So maybe not a salmon, which is a very flavorful fish, but towards the sort of white side of the fish, like tilapia, Mahi Mahi is another one. So what we're going to do is we're going to lightly season the fish, and we're going to make a sauce, a tequila lime sauce, cream sauce.
Ooh.
And then we're going to kind of combine those together.
That
so on
good.
The fish, it's awesome. So on the fish, what we're going to do is take a little bit of salt. You don't have to go overboard. Nick loves sea salt, and so do I. It has a nice feel to it, doesn't it?
It's nice.
It's crunchy. It's
It cooks better. It's a better flavor. It's actually harder to oversalt if you use sea salt.
I agree, because it's big enough you can feel it.
Mm-hmm.
With the normal table salt, you're like, uh-oh, I don't know how much is on there. I can't tell. And oversalting's not nice.
No.
We're going to put a little cumin on again, because this is sort of a south of the border take on it.
He's from Texas, so you know, he has to have tequila,
right.
Has to have cumin, but we're humoring him.
That's south of the Wisconsin border, right?
It is south of Wisconsin border.
All right, so a little, we'll season both sides lightly again. It's not, we don't have to go overboard, because this is a delicate fish. You wouldn't want to put a whole bunch of flavor on it, or you wouldn't even know you're eating fish anymore, which might work for you.
It might work for me.
But not for people that like fish.
I do like fish that is fried enough with enough ketchup, it might be chicken. That is good. That is good fish.
All right, so we've got our fish ready. That was simple, right?
Very
simple.
So now
what we're going to do is we're going to put a little olive oil in a hot pan. And, whoops, it doesn't take much.
Near that pan on a high heat.
That's right.
We're going to just sear that.
That's exactly right. So all we're doing with the fish, you know, unlike something like a thick cut of beef or a thick cut of pork, you don't cook it very long. If you cook it real long, it's not nice at all. So that's exactly right. What we really want to do is sear it. So we're going to wait just a second, and we want that oil. And we didn't put enough oil like to have it sitting in a puddle of oil. We just have enough oil that we're sure it's not going to stick itself to the bottom of the pan. So I think we're good and warm. So we're going to go ahead and put it in. We want to hear that. That's
perfect.
What we want to hear, right there.
It'd be better if it's a fillet, but you know.
So we're going to let it sit for about a couple of minutes. And what we're trying to get is that crust on it, right? Get a little bit of the tan crust onto the fish, and then we'll flip it. While that's going, we're going to make ourselves a nice tequila lime cream sauce.
I can get behind this.
There you go. This is simple. Could not be easier. What we're going to do is take a little bit of butter. And butter is just, again, as a base for the sauce. We want to be able to cook the vegetables. And, you know, you don't want to cook them on the dry pan. You want to cook them in a little bit of sauce, so we use the butter. We're going to use a little bit of diced onion and some cilantro and some garlic, and we just toss them all in. This could not be easier. Toss them all in. We're going to use a little lime juice. You say how much. We're going to have that in the ingredients list, but it's not like, oh no, I yep. used a little bit different amount. And then this right here is white tequila blanco, and we're going to pour that in. Now when you're cooking with tequila or vodka or rum, you want to make sure it boils to get the alcohol out, because you don't want to be serving this to your kids and they all get hammered. That's not good.
That's not good at all.
So as you can see, we're going to let it come to a boil. What we're going to do is reduce it by about half. So what reducing means is we just leave it boiling, and when it boils, the liquid goes away, so it gets a little bit less volume, right? So we're just watching that and making sure when we get about half as much as we have now, then we're going to fold in cream, heavy cream, and more butter until we get like a creamy sauce.
Perfect.
All right, so I can flip this with my hands. We got tongs somewhere, maybe we do. If not, I could definitely flip it. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna see how we're doing. See how it does stick a little bit to the pan, even with oil. If you didn't use oil, it would really stick to the pan. So we're gonna give it a flip. There, that has a nice, see how it has a nice tan crust on it?
Yep.
All right, as you can see, Nick, we've reduced here. And so what we're gonna do now is add our heavy cream. And we're gonna kind of blend it in just like this.
So is heavy cream what makes it a cream sauce?
Good guess.
Man.
And butter helps a little bit too when you get right down to it. Never bad to have a little butter. We are in Wisconsin after all.
It is a dairy state.
So now we're getting that cream sauce going.
Oh, look at that, that's beautiful.
And the fish is, I would say, 95% done. So it's all gonna get done at the same time. And when that happens, you cheer.
And this was a really quick recipe to make. Perfect for weeknights if you're in a time crunch.
Absolutely.
Including prep.
10 minutes, 15 max.
It was so easy.
Yep.
And we sell the frozen fish. We just defrosted that in cool water, and it only took us 30 minutes.
That's exactly right.
It might take
right.
you a little bit more depending on how much you're defrosting, that type of thing. But so from taking the fish out of the freezer, defrosting it, prepping all the chopping, and then making this has been 45 minutes tops.
Absolutely. From store to table. All right, we're ready. So what we're going to do to plate this, I'd like to plate it just to finish the experience. And so what we're going to do is take a spoon. Here, there we go. This is perfect. And what I like to do for this is to spoon a little of the sauce onto the plate, like so. And what we're going to do is we're going to sit the fish on that bed of sauce. What that does is it's like a sponge, and it starts pulling that sauce up into the fish.
Hear that sizzle still?
Yes, it is perfect. And you'll also notice, hey, I've gone to restaurants and they do that. It's a very common way to plate a beautiful fish like this Mahi Mahi. And then to finish it, we will spread a little sauce on top. And there we have our south of the border Mahi Mahi with a tequila lime cream sauce. And I know you're not a big fish
guy.
Yeah,
you go and try it.
But I will have to give it a try. It should be just right. But I'll let
Flakes
you know.
Flakes nicely?
Yes, it does. It's
That's
a beautiful fish.
That's right?
That's right. It's a beautiful fish.
Thanks for watching. I'm
Perfect.
Assuming
very
it's good.
Very good. It's very good.
This is an easy recipe to make. We have everything you need at Lake Geneva Country Meats. Stop on by. We may be Lake Geneva Country Meats, but we have great fish too. Uncle Mark, thanks for showing me how to do this. I'll maybe use this on a pescatarian front.
There you go.
See you soon at Lake Geneva Country Meats. And for the full recipe, click on the link below.